You're listening to an archived Cabral Concept podcast. After listening to this show, check out the most up-to-date podcasts available at stephencabral.com/podcasts or search directly on iTunes. And now, welcome to the Cabral Concept, where board-certified naturopath and integrative health practitioner Dr. Stephen Cabral shares how he was diagnosed at the age of 17 with a life-altering illness and given no hope for recovery. It was only after studying and traveling all over the world did he discover how to combine ancient Ayurvedic healing practices with state-of-the-art naturopathic and functional medicine to fully rebalance the body and re-energize it with life. It's time to discover how to get well, lose weight, and finally feel alive again. And now, here's your host, Dr. Stephen Cabral.
I'm excited to get started. It's our Motivation and Mindset Monday. And today, I'm answering the question that just keeps coming up over and over and over. And it says, if I can do one thing, if there's one thing I can do to lose weight and overall feel better, what is that? You know, what's that one thing I can do? I don't have a lot of time in my schedule. I can't always go to the gym. I have a family or I'm in a relationship or I work a lot. What's that one thing I can do? And you know what? I'm very happy to share this episode with you today. And the reason is this is the one thing I've used in my private practice for over 10 years that I've been giving as the solution to most people's issues. I do it myself. I've been doing it myself for many, many years. And I can tell you it's the number one thing I did to turn around my health, but also it's a thing that I keep doing to this day. If I do nothing else correct for the day, I am absolutely doing this. And of course, I try to live that healthy lifestyle and all of those specific things, but even when I'm traveling, even when I'm on the road, even if I'm getting on a plane at 5 a.m, whatever it might be, I'm doing this one thing. It's that important. So let's go over that now. Enough suspense. So the one thing that you can do to lose weight, get well, and live longer is replace whatever you're doing right now for breakfast with an AM smoothie, a morning smoothie, a breakfast smoothie, however you want to think about it. And I'm going to tell you why. I'm going to give you the exact reasons, and you can then choose at the end of this to do what you feel is best for you. Okay, so right now, the majority of people throughout the world are doing maybe three different things for breakfast, okay? They're either A, just skipping breakfast altogether, and they might just have a coffee or they might have a tea, and they just skip breakfast altogether, and then they wait until either mid-morning or lunchtime to have their first meal. Okay, so that's one. The second option is they wake up, and like most people, they have a glass of juice, and they have a bowl of cereal or some type of like baked type good. Okay, they put in a pastry type item, a Pop-Tart, whatever it might be. But a lot of people just do cereal, okay? Something like that. And the third are the people who think that they're doing something healthier for themselves, and they're waking up and they're having a nice big breakfast of eggs and maybe some bacon or some chicken sausage or an actual meal, you know, for breakfast in that morning. And then, so those are three options. So let's go through them one by one. Let's say the pros and cons. So one of the pros to not eating breakfast at all is that you're not taxing your system, right? So you're not asking it to break down all this food, which allows you typically to have more energy, at least for a little while. It also allows for that process of autophagy to take place, which simply means that your body then doesn't have a lot of new proteins and things coming in, so it can keep working on the detoxification and cleansing process. And as we've seen, that leads to a healthier overall individual, a longer lifespan, all of that great stuff. But a lot of times when you don't eat for breakfast, what happens is you get rebound hunger. So you're eating more later in the day, or you're taking caffeine in as a substitute for energy. So you're drinking more coffee. Or what happens is by not eating, you actually start to tap into actual muscle tissue stores for energy if your own glucose, your own liver glycogen, all of that has already been used up. And it can also put into you to more of a fight or flight based response, a survival response, because you're technically, you've been up for a few hours. It's not like you're just relaxed. If you are, it's a different story. But if you're in traffic or you're on your way to work and you're stressed, you're creating a survival based response, and that's going to increase cortisol. Your body needs some type of fuel source and it doesn't have it. So it will use you as that fuel source. Okay. The second one, if you do juice and you do cereal for breakfast, well, you are literally just eating sugar for breakfast, and you are going to dip in blood sugar mid-morning, so you're going to be that much hungrier. You're also most likely not going to be working out right away, so that all that sugar from the juice without the fiber, you're getting 30 plus grams of sugar. I've written many articles on this, and you're getting the cereal, which is just processed flour, and you're getting another at least 40, 50 grams from there. So you're over 70 grams of pure sugar going into your system with nothing to really block it. And that's going to lead to weight gain, inflammation, which leads to disease. And that inflammation then does not allow you to live a long, healthy, good quality of life. So that's not a good choice. That would be the worst. The last option, C or three, is the wake up, make an omelet for breakfast, even if it's egg whites, some vegetables, maybe a little bit of oatmeal, you know, something very, very, as we would call, healthy. But here's the issue. Unless you have a relaxed morning and you have a strong, robust digestive system, you're going to be going into, again, that more of a stressed response. You're going to be trying to digest all that heavy food. And for a lot of people, that energy would be better served going to help clean up the body, make the body stronger, and also use that energy to start your day. Because you don't want to weigh yourself down that heavy first thing in the morning. Not for most people. Not for most people. I'm going to go into that. And because, again, if you put in that much food into your stomach, your body is that it has to use a tremendous amount of energy to bring the blood to the stomach, to produce hydrochloric acid, to produce enzymes, to drop bile, to do all of those things that require digestion. And that energy then is not going to the rest of your body. Plus, the other thing is I do so much food sensitivity testing. Again, if you haven't had your food sensitivities tested, we do them from what's called an IgG perspective. That means that these are things that affect you from a latent response after 24 hours after eating it, which means that what did you eat 2 days ago? Because you could be sensitive to those things, and that's causing inflammation, that's causing headaches, that's causing joint pain, that's causing all sorts of different things, skin rashes and, you know, digestive upset. And you can test that by just a simple at-home little finger poke. And again, we offer those. We send them literally all around the U.S. I wish we could send them all around the world. We just don't have that ability yet. Our lab is U.S. only. And literally, just by doing that test right at home and sending them in, we send you the results of what you're sensitive on. And I say this because so many people are sensitive to eggs. So you think you're doing this great thing, and then you end up being sensitive to eggs. And it's mainly the egg white, so you can't get around it because a lot of people say, well, I'm being healthier, I'm only eating the egg white. That's very debatable. I would not be in that camp. And the egg whites have twice as many allergens as the yolk. And I'm not going to get into why that is really today, but just think about it. Like, that white is the developing animal. That is that chicken. And the yolk is a lot of the nutrients that are going to feed that. So you have to look at it from an actual protein, albumin source. And although there's 3 grams of protein in the white and 3 in the yolk, there's still more allergens in the white itself. All right, so now we've gone over the 3 different breakfasts. So why do I recommend the AM smoothie? Well, it's the best of all worlds, meaning like you're going to wake up, you're going to use one of the recipes that I recommend, which might be 8 ounces of water and 8 ounces of like a nut milk or just all water if you want. So it could be, a lot of times this is what I'll do. Sometimes I'll just put in 16 ounces of water and I then put in a teaspoon to 2 teaspoons of coconut cream. And then what I do from there is I'll add in 2 cups of fruit. So, and I just pick the fruit that I want. Again, this is for me. You might not be able to have that much fruit right now because, you know, maybe you're not as active or maybe you're trying to lose weight, but you can certainly do 1 cup. That would be okay. And you can pick berries because that's lower glycemic. And then you can add in some greens if you want. You can add in some flax seeds or chia seeds if you'd like. And then you're going to add in, I recommend an all-in-one. There are so many different companies that make them. We make ours direct from the actual manufacturer, so we know where we're getting everything. We do third-party testing. We only use functional medicine-based multivitamin. So what's your all-in-one? Well, literally, it's this thing that costs like $1.50 to $2. That's it per serving. So it's a very inexpensive breakfast, like cheaper than cereal and juice. And you get a multivitamin, you get your minerals, you get your electrolytes, you get everything all-in-one. Plus you get your protein, and it comes from a vegan source, which is rice and pea protein. So you can do that. Now, of course, you can use anyone's. I'm not necessarily promoting the one that we do. The one that we do, we believe in, and that I use my family, and I can obviously recommend to all the people that I work with because I feel confident about it. But even in my wellness center in Boston, we offer 3 different varieties because I'm not here to sell you a specific supplement. I do it because I need to make sure that people are getting good quality ones. But you could also use a hemp protein. You could use one of those other great types of protein as well, and then just take a good quality functional medicine, maybe vitamin on the side. And that right there is a tremendous breakfast. Why? Because you get all of your antioxidants from the fruits and the greens. You get good fiber from the fruits and the greens, and also if you add in some flax or some chia. You're getting your protein from a hypoallergenic source like rice or pea or hemp, and then you're getting a lot of fluid, a lot of liquid. And instead of dehydrating your body with just more caffeinated substances, or if you're going to have the coffee, fine. Have it after your smoothie so you're not stimulating the body without some good nutrition in there. And really that sets you up for the day because it makes so much smoothie. It makes like two big containers of like two 20-ounce glasses. And you can bring it with you. And we have people basically time release it throughout the morning. They're drinking it over the course of an hour or more. And it's super hydrating their body. So they're getting lots of fluid, lots of water. They're getting antioxidants. They're getting fiber. They're getting good quality protein. And since it's blended, your body doesn't have to use all that extra energy to digest a big breakfast. So that is what I absolutely do recommend. I use it for every single person in my practice. And the reason is that it works across all boards. There is simply nothing healthier in the world because it's fruits and vegetable based and a hypoallergenic protein. It's time release, so it's not going to spike your blood sugars from the fruit because there's enough fiber and there's enough protein for that not to happen. And you're time releasing it yourself. You know, it's just kind of chugging it down all at once. I honestly cannot make a higher recommendation than that. If you don't do anything else, I would do that. I mean, that is really the truth. That's what I would do. It changes lives just doing that one specific thing. Because by doing an AM smoothie, what does it also do? Well, it crowds out all the other bad stuff you would be doing, like going for a coffee and picking up a muffin or a pastry or one of those like breakfast bars, which are not healthy for you. Again, they're all packaged. They're not good for you. So I could go on and on. I could probably talk about this for an hour, you know, and maybe I will one day, but not today. So that's the recommendation that I do. If you want to use exactly what I do, it is those berries. We offer those recipes for, you know, for free on the website. The one that I use is the all-in-one support shake. You can just go to drbraldetox.com and click on the support shake of the top, the detox shake. And you could also just go to stephencabral.com/store and you can click on the daily all-in-one shake as well. Daily detox shake. We're probably switching the name to daily support shake because people don't know what detox is, but basically it's cleaning your body on a daily basis. And hey, that's how you reduce inflammation. That's how you live longer. That's the way it works. That is exactly what I do. It's exactly what I use in my practice. I do it every single day and I cannot give a higher recommendation to you to do at least the smoothie that I want. And then again, you choose the powder that might work best for you. Thank you once again for tuning into the Cabral Concept. I want to sincerely thank you for your support of this podcast. I couldn't do it without you, and I mean that. I truly do. I also want to make sure you knew that we now have multiple ways for you to find your answers to the most difficult health, wellness, weight loss, and anti-aging questions. You can find podcast-specific topics like thyroid, adrenal, hormones, sleep, digestion, Ayurveda, and many more at stephencabral.com/podcasts that will then link you to your favorite Apple, Spotify, and other podcast players. Plus, all new podcasts and weekly exclusive video content is being added to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/Stephen Cabral. And that's Stephen with a PH. Head on over and subscribe so that you don't miss any of the exclusive content. Lastly, if you've ever found any of my podcasts or books to be helpful, I would really appreciate it if you could leave a review on iTunes or your favorite media player for the podcast. Rating and subscribing to the YouTube and podcast allow me to reach more and more people and help spread my mission of healing throughout the world. Thank you again for being a part of this movement.